you only played the harp for a short time, you will likely immediately recognize the noise that I'm talking about. It can be really frustrating, especially when you don't know where it comes from or how to avoid it, which is why today I'm going to talk about different types of buzzes and the solutions that will help you enjoy the beautiful sound of your harp without any interruptions. I will also show you how to troubleshoot any buzzes you may get. Feel free to download the printable cheat sheet where you can see the whole process explained step by step. You'll find the link in the description of this episode. A buzzing noise may come from a few different sources, and the first step is to try and tell where is it coming from. Sometimes it could be a problem with a part of your instrument, perhaps one of the parts not behaving quite as it should and requiring a technician's help. Having your harp serviced regularly will definitely help to minimize the risk of random noises coming from your instrument. Most of these buzzes are nothing serious, but it's worth keeping track of them if they start appearing at any point between your regular service appointments. It's a good idea to get a small notebook, it could be the back of your practice notebook, or even a digital space where you can follow the history of what's been happening with your harp. For example, I keep track of the strings that had to be replaced, and in that folder I also make a note of any noises or other problems that I might notice. Luckily, there weren't too many. With noises that seem to come from the harp, it's always a good idea to check whether it's really something to do with the instrument or if it's actually something else in the room that's causing a buzz. Main suspects are radiators and anything made from metal, but it can also be your tuner if some parts are touching the harp. So try removing tuner and any cables, and then you can also try moving the harp to a different room to see if the noise is still there. If you're not sure where the noise is coming from, don't be afraid to ask. Your harp teacher will be able to tell whether it's something to do with the way you play or whether you may need to contact a harp technician for an extra check of your harp. Now, when it comes to buzzes that are within our hands' control, there are two main kinds of buzzes that can come from our fingers. The first type of buzz happens when the string where we're going to replace our finger on is already vibrating. If we're too slow and perhaps a bit hesitant, we won't be able to completely stop the string from vibrating, but instead, it will carry on and end up sounding distorted when finger comes in contact with the string. The second type of buzz usually comes from one of our fingers finding itself too close to a neighboring string that is vibrating. So for example, you play a C chord followed by a D chord. And when playing so close to strings that are already vibrating, it may happen that one of your fingers will accidentally touch these vibrating strings. It can be especially noisy if the vibrating string touches one of your fingernails. Buzzes caused by how we play are in a sense similar to the ones that may be coming from the harp. If your instrument is regularly serviced, you're less likely to have weird noises coming from there. And if your technique is solid and confident, you also minimize the risk of buzzes coming from your fingers. There are a few aspects of harp playing technique that you want to pay attention to if you want to avoid buzzing. First, your fingers 2, 3, 4 need to keep pointing down while giving the space to the thumb to stay up. When they do, you can achieve point number 2, which is placing your fingers from below. You need to make sure fingers 2, 3, 4 don't find themselves above the thumb, as this may lead to sliding, and that's one habit that can be really hard to let go of. If you want to know more about sliding, check out one of my earlier episodes where I talk about that. I'll put it for you here and in the description of this episode. Next, you need to know where you're going, and for that, practice placing your hands in advance, as that's the best way for your fingers to become really confident about placing. Place fast, play slow is one of the best practice strategies for that. The key is always to stay calm, take your time, and be confident that you will be able to solve the problem. Very often when a buzz happens, we get a little bit anxious and we try to be super careful about what we're going to do next. But our first instinctive reactions may not always be helpful here. For example, you may be trying to approach strings more slowly, but if your buzz happens when you're trying to replace your finger on a string that's already vibrating, this may only make it worse, as what you actually need is getting your finger on that string confidently, as if you are going to damp it in one swift movement. Another not so helpful strategy that we sometimes turn to if we think that a noise was caused by one of our fingernails is trying to keep those fingernails away from the harp and doing some version of approaching strings from above, as if you were trying to tame a wild animal. But this doesn't really work because first, it generates a lot of extra movement here, possibly some sliding, and then your fingernail is actually more likely to eventually end up getting even closer to the string. So you need to keep your fingers low and place from here, from below. And I know it feels counterintuitive, but it really works, as I'll show you in just a moment. Here's what to do when a buzz happens. Step 1. First, make sure about the source of the buzz. If it's something in the room, remove whatever makes the noise or try to move yourself and the harp to another room. If it's something to do with the harp, it may be worth contacting a harp technician to see if it's something that needs to be dealt with soon or whether it can wait until your harp's next service. Step 2. Which hand is causing a buzz and then which finger is causing the buzz? If you're not sure, it's worth asking a harp teacher for help. Step 3. What kind of a buzz is it? Does it happen when you're trying to place and play a string that's already vibrating, or are you actually accidentally touching nearby vibrating strings? If you're lucky enough for the answer to be both, you deal with them one at a time. Here's what to do depending on the type of the buzz that you're looking at. If it's the first type of buzz, where you're aiming to place your finger on a string that's already vibrating, the key here is to approach and land on with confidence. This means that when we're placing our finger, two things are actually happening. First, we dump the vibration and then pluck. And you can practice it in exactly this way. After you've made the strings vibrate, you repeat placing fingers on the strings so it can be as clean and quick as possible. So you want your fingers to be really sure of what they're doing and where they're landing, and even if you're still playing quite slowly, you want to be able to place them on the strings with confidence. A quick side note here. If you're replacing your fingers on strings that are already vibrating, even with very confident and clean placing, you may still experience some faint noise. It will usually be a little bit stronger with the thicker and longer strings lower on the harp and softer when it comes to the strings near the top, and on some harps it may be a little bit louder than on others. You may or may not hear it in a recording, and you're more likely to hear it when you're the one playing and you're right next to the harp. This kind of faint sound is hard to avoid because it comes from your other fingers dumping the vibrating strings, so please don't obsess about this, as it's unlikely that someone in your audience will hear it. Of course, you want to eliminate the loud kind of buzz that we spoke about earlier, but once you know your harp and you can tell what these two feel like, you will easily be able to tell the difference. For the second type of buzz, where the strings that are causing problems are not the ones we're immediately going to play, but the neighboring vibrating strings, our aim will be to avoid touching them. Of course, there are some techniques where you will be dumping before playing, but unless you're doing that, it's not really practical to dump every note before we play another. So our aim here is to place in a way that allows us to avoid touching other strings. That's one of the reasons why harp teachers keep reminding you to have your fingers pointing down when you're working on your technique. When you do this, there is less risk that any part of your finger would touch any of the nearby strings. With the second kind of buzz, you can do some slow motion practice. Start with your fingers low and then slowly begin to bring them closer to the string. Slow enough so you can keep controlling how far is your finger and your fingernail from the neighboring strings. If you've seen my video on sliding, you have seen me explaining how your fingers need to work as if they were wheels of an airplane getting ready to land. This is definitely a good moment to remind them about that. You can first do that without playing anything else, so no strings are vibrating, and then you can play the earlier section of a piece and try it in real-life conditions. If a buzz happens as you play a larger, connected section, you practice this in exactly the same way. For example, let's suppose you're practicing a snippet that sounds like this. And while playing, you notice that your second finger buzzes when placing D, as it happens to touch the string below. So you can start practicing placing just these two fingers, thumb and second, so you can do it really slowly and keep your second finger in check. Then you can play the three notes before, cause the strings to vibrate, and try placing again, slowly, so you can keep your second finger away from the C. And gradually you can start closing the gaps while playing slowly. And if everything is fine, you can start increasing the speed if you need to. Just make sure that whatever speed you're playing at, you can still keep your fingers low and pointing down. To make this whole process easier, I've created a simple one-page cheat sheet that shows you what to do when you encounter a bug, step by step. To download it, follow the link in the description of this episode. Print it off and keep it near the Harp so that you can stay calm if a bug happens, because you will know exactly what to do. If you like this episode, do let me know in the comments and remember to subscribe so you get notified about future episodes of the Coffee Break Harp. I will see you here next week. Take care for now. Bye!